In the last lecture, we had seen the laws of refraction. In that, we saw the normal, the incident ray and the refracted ray all lie in a same plane. And second law, we have seen that the sine of the angle of ratio of the sine of the angle of incident to that of the sine of the angle of refraction, that ratio is constant. This law is given by the scientist whose name is Snell. This is also called the Snell's law of refraction. Today we will see some consequences of refraction. See, in the last period we have seen that when the light ray propagates from denser medium to rarer medium, see, it comes from denser medium to rarer medium, so it will not follow that original path. It moves away from the normal. See, this is denser medium and this is rarer medium. Hey, how can say this particular medium is rarer, particular medium is denser? So, as we saw in the last period, the ratio of sine I to that of the sine R, this ratio is constant, and that constant is a numerical term that is called refractive index. If the refractive index of particular material, a particular medium is more, then it will be called denser. Okay, just a comparative study. So, if we have a denser medium, its refractive index will be definitely more. If we have a rarer medium, its refractive index will be less. Okay, just see, you know, the ray of light is propagating from denser to rare, it moves away from the normal. And if it comes from rarer to denser, it moves towards the normal. Just see, here the angle of incident is more, angle of refraction is less. Here the angle of incident is less, angle of refraction is more. So when we calculate the refractive index, see, according to the Snell's law of refraction, sine of I to that of sine of R, this is the refractive index of second medium. So here the second medium is a rarer medium, here the second medium is denser medium. Just see, this is the refractive index of second medium with respect to medium 1. So, just see, denominator having R here in both the cases. So, in this case, denominator is less. Means sine of less angle will be less and hence this value will be more. So, when you divide any number with a less number, so overall value will be more. So, here the mu, that is the refractive index for this medium, will be more as compared to this medium. Okay. Now, one more thing. Principle of reversibility. So when a light ray, after suffering any number of reflection and refraction, has its final path reversed if travel back along its entire initial path. Okay, see how, when you keep any mirror, say we have an incident ray, it coming in a air, suppose some denser medium here, so it moves towards the normal. And suppose here we are keeping a mirror kept normal to it. So whatever the path travelled by the ray, it completely reverse. Okay, it take complete U-turn, means it reverse back in the same path. So whatever the path travel, say it coming like this, after reflection from this mirror, it travel back same path. Is it clear? So, what is mathematical use of this? See, if the refractive index of say this medium, say it is mu. If refractive index of this medium with respect to this is mu, so we can, using the principle of reversibility, the refractive index of its medium opposite to that, means refractive index of this medium is mu, so refractive index of this medium with respect to this will be 1 by mu, means it is a reciprocal of mu. So if this is a medium, say whatever it is, its refractive index is mu, so its refractive index will be 1 by mu with respect to this. Means we can say, if this is mu, so refractive index of 1 with respect to 2 will be 1 by mu. Okay, means mu to 1 into mu 1 to, that always be 1. This is the mathematical use of the principle of reversibility. This we will use very widely in so many numerical questions. So we saw, when the refraction takes place, when the light travel from one medium to another medium, so refraction takes place. And during the refraction, what are the quantities, what are the properties of light is changed? See, as we saw, as speed changes. See, in a denser medium, speed decreases, and if comes, if light comes in a rarer medium, its speed increases. And one more thing, its wavelength also changes. Okay, so you know the light is an electromagnetic wave, it possesses wavelength. So its wavelength is changes. Its intensity will also be changed. So one thing remains unchanged, and that is frequency. The frequency of the light is not changed. So maybe the color also may be changed. That depends upon some wavelength. Maybe, but sometimes it's yes or sometimes it's not. Okay. So what are the quantities changes? Speed changes, intensity changes, wavelength changes, but frequency remains same. Is it clear? Now today we will discuss what is the lateral shift. Suppose we have a glass slab and a light ray comes like this. Here is a normal. If there is no change in medium, it travels in this path, but there is a change in medium, so it moves towards the normal like this, and here it is a normal. Here the angle I, here the angle of refraction. Now just see, now the ray is now in a denser medium, it comes back. So this is the shift that we have to calculate. So let's give the name. Say we have a PQ is the incident ray, QR refracted ray in the denser medium, and R S is the emergent ray. Suppose its refractive index is mu. Okay, here we have a normal N N dash, and this part of the denser medium, its width is suppose T. Okay, its width is suppose T. Just see. See, when the ray is coming from rarer medium to denser medium, it moves towards the normal, and when it comes from denser medium to rarer medium, the same medium, it moves away from the normal. Here is the normal prime and double prime. So here that is the shift. This we have to calculate. This we will calculate in terms of the width of the this glass slab. Okay. Entry. Emergent ray and index of glass. Okay, now just see this angle. This is angle R, this is angle I. This ray is prolonged with this PQ ray, so this angle will also be I. Okay, you know children, when two rays are intersecting, these two angles are always be equal. It is called vertical opposite angle. So angle PQN will always be equal to this angle. Okay, just give the name R. Suppose it is S. Okay, this angle N dash Q S. This angle will also be I. So what about this angle? This angle, can you say this angle? Total angle is I. This angle becomes R. So very easily you can identify this angle. This angle we can write, it is I minus R. Clear? Now we have to express X, means what is the lateral shift, how much the emergent ray is moving away from the initial ray, how much part here. To see the refraction takes place, we can write this angle in terms of this, means here in this triangle, QN prime R. To see in this triangle, okay, QN This is the thickness of this part. Whatever the denser medium. Now, just see. Can we get this value? QR in terms of R. Just see. This is a right angle triangle, children. This is a right angle to this. Okay. This angle is 90 degree always. So, we can get QR QN dash upon QR. See, this is base upon hypotenuse. This will be equal to cosine of angle R. Is it clear? So, by this we can write QR is equal to, see, the base upon hypotenuse. Base upon hypotenuse. This is equal to cos. So, we can get the QR. QR is equal to QN dash upon cos R. This is the equation number 1. Now children, see this triangle. In triangle QRS. Just see, RS is perpendicular on this line. So we can get this is 90 degree. So we can get this X here. So RS upon QR. You see, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. For this triangle, this is hypotenuse. And what about this angle? So as we know, this angle is I minus R. So this will be sine of this angle, I minus R. Sine of angle, I minus R. So we'll get RS that we had to find. X is equal to QR times sin angle I minus R. Now, from equation 1, we can get the value of QR from equation 1. X, we can get QR, that is QN dash upon cos R into sin I minus R. So, this is the shift. Now Q and dash we can get the thickness, whatever the thickness. So here, in general we can write that lateral shift or lateral displacement X is equal to thickness T times sin I minus R upon cosine of R. So, what we can conclude here? See, we can conclude one thing, that shift, because see this formula, basically it depends upon how thick it is. Means, the denser medium is how much wide it is. So, more the wide of the denser medium, there will be more shift. Okay, one thing. And second, it also depends upon I and R. Okay, basically we can say it depends upon I. So if the angle I is more, then also the shift will be more. Okay.